When examining Earth's surface, it appears like an extremely rugged planet. Mountains, canyons, volcanoes, and the incomprehensible depths of the world's oceans are incredibly challenging extreme points for a human to conquer. So in this video, I'd like to shed some light upon the 6 most extreme highs and lows of planet Earth. In order to have a reference level for these 6 extreme locations, we'll be using Earth's geoid as a normal null. The geoid is a shape first described by German mathematician Johann Carl Friedrich Gauss, who was in search of a mathematical description of Earth's surface. Instead of taking the actual distance from a point on the surface to the core of our planet, the geoid is based on the sum of centrifugal and gravitational energy acting upon a specific point on the surface. Under perfect conditions, this results in the water surface of the oceans representing the normal null. In the hypothetical scenario that no tides, currents, or weather is acting upon it. On land, the geoid follows the relief in a smooth manner, increasing in level when large objects like mountains are in the way, and decreasing in level where valleys and flat plains are present. The resulting shape is a very smooth, yet irregular and imperfect sphere, which perfectly incorporates the 2 strongest forces on Earth's surface, the centrifugal force from its rotation and the gravitational forces from its mass. We'll start off with the most obvious contender for an extreme spot on Earth's surface. Due to the deep dip of Earth's geoid in the Indian Ocean, the Himalayas are pretty much located at geoid's normal null. Even though this doesn't help the Everest its size, it is nevertheless the highest point on Earth's surface compared to the normal null. The Everest stands out with a staggering 8,844 meters when counting the highest rock, and 8,848 meters when counting the highest surface level of ice and snow on its peak. First ascended in 1953, it remains a dangerous challenge for anybody who attempts to climb it. In comparison to the other locations of this list, however, it is one of the easier accessible places. While around 5,300 people have successfully summited the Everest, the lowest point on Earth's crust, as seen from its geoid, has only seen 8 visitors since its discovery. The first hint of its existence surfaced in 1875, when the British sailing corvette HMS Challenger was blown off course from its original path, since its mission was to collect scientific data about the ocean floor relief. It kept going with its experiments and just so happened to be doing it above the Mariana Trench. The abyss, which opened up underneath the vessel, was too deep for the echo sound testing equipment of that time, which is why no clear results came out, except for the hypothesis that the ocean floor must be deeper than 10,000 meters. It was not until 76 years later that this measurement was verified by another British ship called the HMS Challenger 2, which used more advanced so-called seismic-sized bomb sounding, and the depth was estimated to be around 10,863 meters below the sea level. It was because of these vessels that the lowest point of the Mariana Trench is called the Challenger's Deep. The first manned descent to the bottom of the Challenger Deep had to wait another 9 years, and the crew's manometer now confirmed a depth of at least 10,913 meters. The third location on our list of extreme highs and lows of our planet brings us to the West Bank between Israel and Jordan. The region, which is now the Dead Sea, used to be the seafloor of the Mediterranean Sea with a depth of around 800 meters. The formation of elevated regions between the Dead Sea and the Mediterranean cut off the basin from the Mediterranean Sea around 2 million years ago, and the lake was born. Evaporations lowered the water level until it reached today's level of negative 430 meters compared to the normal null of Earth's geoid around the coast. The fact that the lake has no outflow of water means that any salt brought into the perimeter stays there, which turned the lowest lake in the world also into one of the saltiest bodies of water in the world. So far, all of these places were the extreme spots on our surface in relation to the geoid of our planet. For the second part of this video, we'll explore 3 more extreme spots in reference to the center of mass, also called the point around which our planet is spinning. The first extreme brings us to the volcano Chimborazo, which is found in the Andes of Ecuador. The last eruption of this majestic stratovolcano dates back around 1,500 years, and with its elevation of 6,263 meters, it is the 14th highest volcano in the world. As a side note, the 13 other volcanoes which are taller than the Chimborazo are also all located in South America. While the altitude of this Ecuadorian giant is not the most impressive one, this volcano stands out by being located right near the equator. Due to Earth's intense bulge at the equator, it makes the summit the location furthest away from the center of mass of our planet. The last two record-breaking points that we'll visit in this video are located near the poles. The point on Earth's geoid, which is the closest to Earth's core, is constantly changing, since the glacier ice at the North Pole is constantly melting and freezing again. During the winter, for example, it lays somewhere within the ice sheet, which is slowly thinning out towards the pole. While in the summer, the thinned ice sheet may even have its lowest geoid exactly on the geographic North Pole. When standing in the location of this last extreme point of our planet, you'll be as close to the core of Earth like no other human has ever experienced. Due to the nature of the North Pole ice sheet, this location hasn't been accessible yet though, and we're not even certain at which coordinates it is located. What we do know, however, is that the lowest point on Earth's crust in relation to the center of mass is located somewhere in the Amundsen Basin, which is part of the so-called Polar Deep. The Polar Deep is a massive depression under the Arctic ice sheet caused by tectonic plates separating in the form of a mid-ocean ridge. It is estimated that the lowest point of the Amundsen Basin lays around 4,400 meters below the surface level. Under consideration of the planet's bulge, this means that the lowest point of Earth's crust and the highest point are actually 32,100 meters apart when compared to the distance to the core of our planet. I hope you enjoyed these short dives into the most extreme altitudes of our planet in a literal sense. Feel free to subscribe if you want to see more videos like this one.